Christopher Triplett. Standing at wit's end, Christopher Triplett.
Thank you. Have you ever set a goal that you wanted to achieve? I mean, you planned for this goal. You labored for this goal. In fact, you even went so far as to sacrifice for this goal. Envision this, a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. But you exchange it because you want your dreams to become a reality. Now, you're standing here after you have labored, after you have worked, after you have sacrificed, and you find yourself staring down at the sum total of your results. And there are no words to comfort you because of the fact that your reality of the beauty that you desire has only given you ashes. What do you do? Where do you find the words to strengthen you and to comfort you? The image that you see glaring back at you tells you nothing of saying everything is going to be all right. In fact, the only thoughts that you're having are considered toxic. And these thoughts begin to turn and to churn and to stimulate the sayings that you're saying to yourself. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to remind you where you are. You're standing at your wit's end. As you take your own personal mental journey back to your own Rolodex, please allow me to welcome and to honor contest chair, fellow Toastmasters, and honored guests. I remember my own days, my own moment of finding myself at wit's end. And I'm sure everyone in this room can identify with being at your wit's end. Not knowing the words to say, to affirm to yourself. Not having that image before you that says everything's going to be okay. Not being able to even think the thoughts that will pick you up by your own bootstraps. What can you say to yourself when there's no one there who can encourage you? Well, if you found yourself there, I have come today to encourage you. You see, we're living in a day and time where help is needed. And we suffer in silence too often because it seems as though everyone has their own cares, their own concerns, their own agenda, and we are standing here as representatives with something in our hand that can actually help them. How do I know this? Because just on yesterday, my wife and I were walking the streets of Atlanta, handing out flyers that says, hey, have you ever heard of Toastmasters? And I met four different categories of people. One had never heard of Toastmasters. Two didn't want to know about Toastmasters. Three knew about Toastmasters, but hadn't joined Toastmasters. And then there was number four. Number four says, I know about Toastmasters, and I even agree I need to be in Toastmasters. Now, I asked the first guy, well, what's holding you back? If you already know about Toastmasters, he says, well, the words. The words that someone else laid at my path and said, you'll never amount to anything. There are people out there who are hurting. And we have something precious in our hand that we can actually be a representative to impact their life. Now, how do we do that? Why are we inspired to do that? Because honestly, I think there's everyone in this room who can identify with this message tonight. You yourself have found yourself standing at wit's end, either because you can identify with a relationship that you're wanting to stand up and take its full weight of what it could be, or maybe it's a job that hasn't returned its full investment into your life. And maybe one again could be our DCP goals that we're trying to chase after to secure, but it seems as though the goals themselves are running away from us. However you find yourself that you can identify, when you heard the theme, be honest. Looking for an explosive transformation that you instantly could identify with that. I know I could. And I could because I need my relationships to make sure they transform. I need every one of my goals in life to manifest. I need every one of my DCP goals to be achieved and accomplished, just like you. And I know the daily fight, the daily grind that is required in order to make our dreams become a reality. Now, here's what I want to say to you and how I'm going to encourage you. Every day, I have to make a conscious choice because I remember my own wormwood and gall standing there days of not having to know the answers of how to pick myself up. And so here's how I'm going to suggest to you, something that may serve you. I start my day like this. In the lowest form of my personhood, I stand in my mirror and I say, I am Christopher. C for creative. H for honest. R for righteous, I for inspirational, S for supportive, T for thankful, O for opulent, P for powerful, H for humble, E for effervescent, and R for righteous. I encourage you that it may serve you to turn the days when you're standing there at your wit's end to speak to yourself and start your own transformation. Madam Contest Chair.
And at this moment, if we would have all the evaluator contestants please leave the room. You'll go out through this door and then come back in through this door when it's your turn. We'll take just a moment for our evaluation contestants to leave the room. Madam Timers, if we could have 5 minutes on the clock, please. And while our evaluators are making their notes, we're going to just visit with our target speaker here for just a minute and get to know him just a little bit better. Christopher, what a great job you did. That's a very inspiring speech. I'm gonna tell on you just a little bit, and I would like for the people in the room to know that yesterday our scheduled target speaker had a family emergency and was not able to be here. So you can imagine the phone calls that our contest chair was making all across the district. And every single one of the phone calls that came back were, I'm sorry, that's just not enough time. That's just too short of a notice. Understandable, completely understandable, until she got to Christopher and he said, I'd be honored, I'll be there. So. Completely understandable. Things come up and things are, you're not able to do that, and it's great to know when you can and when you can say yes and when you can say no. But you said yes, and I'd like to know why you said yes with such short notice. What enabled you to do that and to bring such a really worthwhile message tonight?
As a young boy, I recall a story that a traveling pastor came to the church and spoke. And he talked about Mr. Opportunity. He said, I'm going to describe to you Mr. Opportunity. He has a bald head. He looks like Mr. Clean. Here's the thing about Mr. Opportunity, though. He has one distinctive characteristic, and that is a long braid that hangs in the front of its face. And when you see Mr. Opportunity, you have to grab onto him and hold him when he approaches. Because once he turns and has passed you, there is nothing you can grab onto. So I saw this as an opportunity.
I love that. And I think that that is one thing that really makes people successful is when they're willing to take those opportunities. I think that's really great. Tell us, what club are you from, and how long have you been in Toastmasters?
I'm with SoCo Toastmasters, Forest Park, which is Southern Company. I've been with Toastmasters for 1 year and 4 months.
And Christopher, what was the impetus? What was the motivation for you joining Toastmasters? When one of those people came along and said, would you like to join Toastmasters? What was your response?
And why?
Okay. There's a story that says,